Restream is a platform used by many streamers to live stream their content across multiple sites. For example, you can use Restream to stream to both Twitch and YouTube at the same time. Whilst extremely useful, it can be confusing to set up, especially if you're used to managing your stream in a particular way. In this video, I'm going to show you how to easily set up Restream with OBS, and configure it to stream to both Twitch and YouTube. In addition to that, I'll also cover some of the really cool features you get from Restream, such as Relay Chat. Stay tuned for the second part of this video, where I show you how to add back in the Twitch docs you're so used to seeing that you lose when you switch over to Restream. To get started with Restream, first head over to their website and you need to set up an account. The link will be in the show notes below. It's easy enough to sign up if you have a Google account, it's just one click. Otherwise, you can make an account with a username and password. Once you're in, you're going to be faced with a dashboard that looks like this. If you're going to use OBS, you'll want to set up the RTMP. So let's go ahead and do that. You'll see here I've got a bunch of channels already listed on the right hand side. With the free version, you can only live stream to two channels at once. So I've highlighted these two that I'm going to be streaming to next. I could easily just untick those and stream to other channels should I wish. But how do you get these channels here in the first place? Well, I'll show you that now. If you just click Add Channel, you'll see the different options. Click on whichever service you'd like and then log in to that service. I'm going to be showing you how to use Restream with Twitch and YouTube. So I've already signed in with both those services and I've got them ticked here, so that's where they'll go live. You don't need to worry about the stream key or the URL because we're actually going to be logging in to Restream through OBS. Updated versions of OBS already have Restream in the settings. We can get over to the settings through File and Settings or the handy Settings button over here. Head over to Stream and select the service Restream.io. From there, you'll be able to choose whether to connect with a stream key or connect your account. Now, I've already connected my account, so you don't see the connect option there, but it'll be there for you. You also want to tick Ignore the Streaming Service Settings Recommendations. Once you've done that, head on over to Output. By standard, your output mode is in Simple, but you may have it set to Advanced. You want to change your video bitrate. Twitch limits your video bitrate to 6000 kbps. YouTube, however, allows much higher. Depending on your internet connection, I would recommend setting your video bitrate anywhere between 15,000 to 20,000 kbps. Restream will ensure that YouTube gets the higher bitrate, and Twitch will limit it down to 6,000 anyway. If you have a slower internet connection, perhaps keep this value at 10,000. And just so you know how it looks in the advanced mode, it's here. Constant bitrate at 20,000. If you're unsure about these other settings, I'm not covering them in this video, but if you'd like a tutorial video on some recommendations for these settings, please let me know and I can prepare something for you. Once that's done, you'll click OK, and what you'll find is these two docs will appear. You'll have your stream information doc and you'll have your channels doc. You may also have a chat doc appear as well. Let me explain these different windows. I never really use the stream information because I manage that within the Restream channel section. So the first thing I do is close that one down. Restream channels show you which of your channels you're going to go live on. So these are the ones that you've ticked. You can also edit what the event is. So this is YouTube, so you can create a new YouTube event or use one that you've previously got set up. And on Twitch, you can do the same. You can edit the title and the category. Once that's done and you're happy with it, you can ignore it. What I tend to do is dock this onto the side and then move chat into the same window. That way, when I'm done organizing the channels, I can just move over to the chat. Now, the Restream chat is pretty cool. Over here, you'll see that you can either post as Restream, as your Twitch, or as your YouTube. If you post a message as your Restream, it will send that message across all the platforms that you want to be streaming to. So everything you have ticked in your Restream channels will have that message posted to it. Alternatively, you can just select one or the other as well. Sometimes there's particular features within the Twitch chat that you might be used to having, for example, auto-completing names or being able to find emojis very easily. That's not going to be available from the Restream chat. But stay tuned because I'll show you how to add the Twitch chat back in here, along with the other Twitch docs that you're used to seeing. Another great feature in the Restream chat is the ability to embed the chat as a browser source on your stream. If you click on the settings button here, Firstly, you can change the appearance of what the chat looks like. So you can go ahead and play around with that until you're happy with how it looks. After you've done that, you can click this button here, Embed in Stream. You can see here that you can embed the chat, just copy the URL, and you can put that into OBS. You can also manage how the embedded chat's going to look. All I need to do here is add a new browser source. I will call this Restream Chat. Put in the browser source, click OK, and the Restream Chat is now ready to display messages. Another great feature with Restream is the ability to relay messages. Often, when you're trying to manage chats in two different platforms, things can get confusing for viewers. You might be responding to something somebody said on YouTube, and the people on Twitch won't understand what you're talking about, and vice versa, because they don't see the messages from the other platform. Recently, in the bot section, Restream implemented a relay mode, and what this does is it will allow the messages coming from one platform to be posted onto the other one. So if a user on YouTube posts a message in chat, Restream will post that message onto Twitch as well, so no viewer is left confused as to what you're talking about. Just remember, if you're using Relay Chat, but you also have the chat displayed on the screen, it's going to display the same message multiple times. So I would suggest either displaying your chat on the stream itself or using the relay mode, but I wouldn't do both. With that all set up, the only thing left for you to do is to click Start Streaming. Now what this will do is it will send your stream over to Restream, and Restream will send it off to the different locations. It really is that simple. Now let's talk about how to get your existing Twitch docs back in. First, you want to head over to Twitch and go to your Stream Manager in your Creator dashboard. This will have links to all of the different docs that you're used to seeing within OBS. A few I like to have are the activity feed, the Twitch chat so I can easily access emotes, and the ad manager so I know when ads are coming up. You need to ensure first that the particular feed or the chat, whatever it is that you're interested in, is showing in your stream manager. If they're not there, simply click on the layout manager up here and edit the panels. Come over to the right hand side here, and any panels which are missing, you can put them in. So for example, there's mod actions, there's unban requests, predictions. You can put any of those into here, and then we'll be able to add them into OBS. Once you've added what you're interested in, click these three dots up at the top of each panel and pop out the panel. Once you've popped out the panel, you'll see that you get a URL. You want to copy that URL. Then you can close this to pop the panel back in again. We'll do this one at a time, but you need to do this for each one that you want to pull into OBS. So we've done the activity feed, so we'll go back to OBS, and now we'll add it in. In OBS, click on Docs, then Custom Browser Docs. Here, you'll see I've already added in the Ad Manager and Twitch Chat, but now I'll add in the activity feed. And I post the URL. Once I click Apply, that's going to pop up. And that's my Twitch activity feed, which I can now pull and put in anywhere that I like, just as it used to be before, and I can add in my other ones too. There's my Twitch chat, and I've got my ad manager here, so I can go ahead and organize those how I like. And it's the same process for adding the others. Custom browser docs, and add in the URL that you get from your stream manager. Hopefully, that's everything you need to know. Restream is a great tool, and even with the free version, it's pretty powerful. The paid version unlocks further capabilities, such as streaming to even more platforms simultaneously and removing the Restream branding. Whilst it's great, it's not without its issues. For example, when using Restream, you lose access to the Twitch audio VOD track, essential if you want to split your audio without the use of third-party tools. And if you have games that use built-in overlays, such as Cult of the Lamb or Baldur's Gate 3, you will lose these too. Hopefully now you have a better understanding of how to set up and use Restream. If you have any questions at all, please post them in the comments below. Alternatively, feel free to join my Discord community. I have a tech support channel there where I'm available to assist via chat and screen shares. Thanks for watching, and I'll catch you again next time.